Okay, what BABOK is? BABOK is a training book. No, it's not a training book. It's not a compliance. It's not a process. It's not a methodology. Okay, but what BABOK is, it will give you the best practices for business analysts across the world, because many experts in their own functional areas or the very seasoned business analysts, they have put their inputs in creating this BABOK. Okay, then it also allows you, so basically you can use the common words due to BABOK. It's not like I'm talking about something else, because you belong to a different industry and I belong to the different industry. But even if, let's say, we are a business analyst, when we talk with respect to our work, there should be some common terms which should be used by both of us, so we can understand what we are doing. So that's why BABOK is there. It will give you common definitions, common vocabulary to all of us. And then it's a reference document for all practitioners. Then again, it will give you the information on how a business analyst can do his work effectively. Okay, these are the knowledge areas we show in pictorially, but we can touch up on them one by one. But herein, I can give you an idea what they are all about. So we'll start with the strategy analysis. Here in strategy analysis, you actually work with the business need, the one which I told you, wherein you can give me the one liner. So here we try to identify the business need. We can try to extract as much as information possible from your business need. We try to do some feasibility studies, and then we try to see how we can work with that business need. So we create a kind of strategy, how we can extract more information from that business need, and we can take it further with respect to the existing IT solution we have. So we try to identify what all the differences are there between the current state of the IT solution and the changes which you are talking about. Then we try to identify those changes on a high level. So that is all strategy analysis is all about. You will be having certain techniques given by BABOK, how to effectively work in this knowledge area. Then you have business analysis, planning and monitoring. This area specifically covers with respect to how you're going to scope your work. Okay. Basically how much effort would be needed to do the business analysis, who all need to participate in the business analysis, what type of challenges you see up front to do the business analysis, and what all tools and techniques probably you need to work with it. And again, you would also write down how you are going to work with the changes which are coming in your way. That is business analysis, planning and monitoring. Then elicitation and collaboration is something wherein you talk to all the stakeholders. Elicitation is basically a common word wherein you try to elicit what your stakeholders are talking about. So basically, whenever you give me the business requirement or business need, it's possible that you are telling me only half of the story, because you didn't think it through what could be the other half. That's also possible, because whenever I talk about, let's say, the same example which you said, that you are hungry, but you just told me that you are hungry, but you didn't tell me, do you need anything else specific in let's say eating? You can tell me that you need to have some curry, or maybe you are happy with, you don't want anything spicy, you want something sweet, or maybe you want something which is in liquid format, not in the solid format, something like that. That you didn't tell me because I didn't ask you, because you thought probably just telling me you're hungry would be enough. In that situation, this elicitation and collaboration will help me. I can sit with you, I can talk to you, I'll try to give you various scenarios, and I'll try to extract as much information as possible from you. Okay. Then requirement analysis and design definition is with respect to, again, it's not whenever we extract information from business, you have to again write it down in an understandable format for everybody. Okay, so whatever business says, they will talk in their own language, then IT will have its own language. So it will be up to you how you're going to write those requirements, which are understandable everyone, then because there would be also a third party which is going to look at your requirement, and that party is known as sponsor, the people who pay for your project. Okay, and that's why the requirement should be smartly written. Okay, and you also need to write down verification criteria in the requirement. So I'll show you them across the course.
Okay.
Yeah. Then requirement lifecycle management is with respect to how requirements are. Mm-hmm. Hello.
Yes, sir.
You had any question, Vishal?
No, sir. So, sir, just a quick question. Now, requirement analysis and design analysis. Requirement lifecycle management, is it something that the requirement might change or update during the entire project? That is what it talks about.
You are asking difference between requirement analysis, design and definition, and requirement lifecycle management, right?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Okay. There is a bit difference in analysis and design definitions, basically with respect to identifying the requirements in understandable format and putting them on paper. So there are various ways with which you can write down a requirement. You can write it textually, you can write it pictorially, you can create some flows or business use cases and all. There are a lot, or you can create some prototype. So there are various ways. So that is what it is talking about, writing down, or let's say making the requirements understandable for everybody. But what is happening in requirement lifecycle management is that the requirements, sometimes it's possible that the information which you are collecting, there are some conflicts with respect to the people who are giving the requirements.
Right.
Okay. Or there could be some changes which are coming later on. Like they told me 10 things now, and suddenly after some time they realized, oh, they wanted 5 things more. And that came in after, let's say, I started my business analysis and I'm halfway. So all those information which are coming in, or conflicts which are there within your stakeholders, then your this skill of requirement lifecycle management comes in picture. Basically, the conflict management is a different story. But whatever changes are coming in your way due to the stakeholders' information or inputs during your business study itself, then how you manage them with the existing work, that is known as requirements lifecycle management. So you can have a change management procedure in place if you're working in waterfall, like the changes which they want to give to you, that should come with certain change control board, which should approve those changes. And then only you can take them, something like that. Or if it is agile, then he has to talk to the product owner, get it verified, approved, and then only you can work on it, something like that. So those procedures, standard procedures, which are set up for making any changes in the requirement, are known as requirement lifecycle management.
Okay.
Okay. Then finally, solution evaluation. Okay.
Sir, just ask a quick question.
Okay, there are many methodologies. Maybe you can just Google it for today. Just go through and just Google different software methodologies, software development methodologies, or software development lifecycle types.
Okay.
Waterfall is wherein you don't start with the next phase unless previous phase has been completed sufficiently. Like I cannot start with development and coding unless the business analysis work is completely done, or my solution designing work is completely done.
Okay.
And once the development is completely done, then only you can start with testing. But because of that, because of waterfall, things are pretty slow. Like I cannot start my next phase, or let's say I as a project manager, if I took resources from my development team, they cannot start it the moment I started the project. So I have to wait for 2 or 3 months till my business analysis work is completed. Then I free up those resources and then I can take the development team, something like that. That's a drawback of waterfall. You don't get a complete picture or a complete idea. The utilization of resources is pretty low, and there would be some time delays, because if first stage is late, then the next stage is also getting affected.
Okay.
Yeah. The finally solution evaluation, which we have, wherein you will again create certain specific criteria like for example, if you have a business requirement, there might be various ways with which you can provide a solution for that. Like as I said, you were hungry, so I can tell you, okay, Vishal, I can have a soup for you, or I can have a sweet or a dessert kind of thing for you, or maybe I can have something in non-veg. Then you can rank all of them with respect to the criteria which I have given. Either you can rank them or I'll rank them, and then I can tell you, or you yourself can pick up what you want to have. So I can tell you, okay, Vishal, I think non-veg is very well cooked. The aroma is very nice. Probably you'll like that. And it is also mitigating your requirement, basic requirement of being hungry. So would you like to have that? So that is what solution evaluation is. You can have multiple solutions. Like it's also possible that you can have something already built product in market. Like the COTS product, the ones which are already created, readily available products which you can buy from the market, or maybe you can tailor them a little bit and you can use them as it is. You just need to install them for your requirement. Okay. Then this is something which you need to, this particular chapter, underlying competencies, we will not go through with this in detail. It will be up to you to read through it. I'll tell you what it is, but it has never come into exams because it is something with respect to your soft skills. Okay, like analytical thinking and problem solving. So as I already said, you need to have some sort of inherent capabilities or qualities. Like you should be able to question the requirement, and you should be able to understand the problem which is depicted by the requirement, and you should be able to solve it. Then behavioral characteristic, like work ethics and all, like whenever you go to the meetings, it's better to go prepared. Maybe just before, 5 minutes before, you should be present at the place. So these are typical work ethics which help a business analyst to give a good impression to its stakeholders. Okay. Then business knowledge. This is something which I am talking about a lot, which I talked about a lot today. So you need to know your business, what is going on, what they're exactly, what their business processes are, which they use to perform their business services. Okay. And then communication skills. It's not only the language you need to know, like you should not be proficient in English, but you should be able to clear in your ideas. So whatever you're talking about, the person in front of you should be able to understand. Okay. Then interaction skills. There's something with respect to your you can say team management skills, not team management skills, but whenever you talk in a bigger group, so then these interaction skills come in handy. Like sometimes you have to give a big presentation to your stakeholders about the requirements and their solution, so you should be able to interact with everyone within the room. So it should not be like few people are able to follow you and few people are not at all understanding what you're talking about. Okay. Then tools and technology, I already said that you need to know specific tools like MS Visio, which I said. If you, I would suggest if you during this course try to buy MS Visio and install it on your own personal laptop and try to go through with that software. Okay.
We use MS Visio extensively. I do process training, so process designing and process
development. Okay, great. Okay, then these are the specific core concept models. I'm not sure if you already know this, but these would be specific definitions.
Okay.
which BABOK would be using, like change is nothing but an act in transformation in a response to a need. So basically, whenever you tell me the business requirement or business need, I would identify what I need to change in my system. Like we'll be talking about current state and future state. So basically, whatever is happening in the system right now, before I implement the changes, would be my current state, and the future state would be the one after my changes are done.
Okay.
It can be, it works to improve the performance of an enterprise, or which improvements are deliberate and controlled through business analysis activities. But here it is talking about improving performance of enterprise in a bigger picture or in a bigger way. Like Basically, if you can understand why projects are coming to any IT department, basically they want to automate something,
right?
Or they want to improve some problems in the system. So they want to, there are either some problems or some issues within the system, or they want to cash upon one of the opportunities which they see. Like, for example, if a very nice software or technology is available in the market, and if they implement it, then probably they can automate various processes which can save them, let's say, one million Indian rupees, something like that, and on annual basis. So that is something which they try to do. So then those requirements are coming in your way, and you're trying to improve your system. Then, yeah, then a need. Need is nothing but, again, what I said just now. It's problem or opportunity. Okay. So it would be on very high level statements which are given by your business stakeholders, operational users. They would tell you why they actually want this particular changes to be done. And that need is also taken further in the project management documents. As in BA, you have to provide that input to your project manager, wherein he can use it for creating a kind of, let's say, overview to the sponsor, so that sponsor also recognizes that, okay, this has to be done, and this is the XYZ amount which I have to give. This would be the timelines. So the other stuff which are there in the project management documents, one of the inputs are given by you with respect to the business thing. Okay, then the solution. Now here it is talking about solution, but that it is again something which is very high level, on an abstract level, because we cannot go through the details in a solution, because of course we are not from development or testing team. Those people would be writing down the exact solution, but on a process flow level, you can provide the solution. Then stakeholder would be everybody who is getting affected or interacting with you for that particular change. So remember, there would be also few stakeholders which might get affected indirectly due to your change, but you don't know them at this moment. But you should not rule them out during your business analysis. If you find that certain specific areas of business are getting affected, then those people are equally important in your business analysis. Then value is nothing but now, for example, this would be a common term you would be using across your business analysis work. So basically it is nothing but what gain you are getting from giving me a particular requirement or giving me a particular business need. That is what value is. So it could be a monetary value, or it could be non-monetary as well. Like, for example, as I said, it can save me 1 million euros, or it could be like improving somebody's work, which cannot be quantified with respect to money. Okay. So that also could be a possibility. So it can be tangible or intangible. Okay. Then context. Context is something like you need to understand why that need has come up. Because now you knew the value, that this is what the gain they are going to get. But what is the context for that? What I meant by context is, sometimes, as I said, they would find out that, okay, there is very nice software in the market. So that would be your context. Okay, so basically they want a better IT solution than what they have right now. Or it could be like some compliance which is coming up. Okay, like suddenly government said that you have to have this regulation. Then you come to know, okay, that's why these business needs are there. Or it is also possible that they want to beat their competitors with some new product. So that could be also another reason for business need. So you have to understand, again, one stage above the business need, why that business need has come up.